Hey, welcome in this new series of small video where I want to explain advanced concepts in the C programming language that I've picked up by coding in it a lot. And so this is aiming to do a very small video on small advanced concepts. And in this first video, I would like to tackle. I mean, this is more like an intermediate advanced, but it's definitely the most useful advanced concept of C, which is pointers to functions. So if you don't know, obviously you know that you have functions in C. So let's see, it's an int. It takes two ints and it returns x plus y. Why not? This is a function. But actually, what a function is just the compiler is going to compile this to some binary data. And the function itself, when you reference it in your code, is just an address in memory where there is a bunch of code. And that's it. So what you can do is actually have a function. And the way you do this is you could have so to declare the type, it's a bit weird, but so the type of this function is this. Up, like this. Oops. So this is a function type. And you can declare a variable with it. So if you say f is equal to, and this works, which is strange when you first learn about it. And the C notation isn't really intuitive with this because it looks like you're defining a function. You should maybe, like if you were really, the more intuitive way would be like this. Like this is a type and this is a variable. But actually you have to put it here because C is a bit weird. And so you can do this and then you can call f of, I don't know, 2 and 4 and do print f. It like this stdio and let's compile this and it's 7 and you see f is actually foo. But of course like just like this it's not really useful, so I have a small example where it is useful. It comes in handy when you use functions in functions. So when you have a function that takes in one of its arguments another function, and you use this function to hook into the main one. So I mean, obviously in many other languages you can do this very easily, but it's not always obvious that you can do it that in C, but you can. And so here I have a print if function that takes an array of ints, which I've already built. It takes a function which is a predicate which will take an int and return true if we want to print it and false if we don't want to print it. And you could see this like a function to filter an array based on the function or to map a function to an array or stuff like this. But let's make a quick predicate called just p. Which takes an int, and let's say we just want to return if x is divisible by 2, and let's call print if of x's and p. And okay, I forgot the equal 0. So here it only printed the even numbers because it called this function every time. So it did a for loop and then every time it called the predicate. And you can use this, of course, this is a very basic example, but there is some functions in the standard library that actually do this. So one of them is QSort, which is a sorting function. And it's a quick sort, like one of the fastest sorting algorithm. And the way to use it, actually, I'm going to take this web page because my man is a bit weird. So it takes base, which is just your array. Nmem is the number of elements in the array. And size is the size of each of those elements. And it takes a comparison function, which gives you two pointers into this this array, which give you, wait, that's the R version. So, and it takes a function pointer for function comparison that takes two pointers into this array, and you return an int. And so this is like similar to str compare, where you return minus one if this one is smaller, or you return plus one if this one is greater, or zero if they're the same. And so let's use this. So here I'm gonna put my array out of order, and I'm gonna create a function compare, which I've already done here. So this is my comparison function. I think I need to do this. Oh no, I don't. I will explain in just a moment. And so, I want to do QSort of x's, that's the base, then the number of elements is 10, then the size of each of those elements is size of int, which is this way for types. Then we have the compare function. And then I'm going to copy paste this to quickly print each element of the array. So after the, I'm going to print it before it's sorted and after. Let's just print a bunch of dashes. Okay. And first time, yes. Okay, yeah. I confuse the order of those, but you see the point. Wait. Why isn't this out of order? Oh no. No, it is. Okay. So the two here is before, like after the three, before the five. I didn't shuffle this a lot, but you can see my points. Like, if I add a big number here, so here it's completely out of order, and here it's sorted it. And you can see that with this function pointer thing, you can make functions that are very, very generic, because you can basically sort any array with a QSort, since it takes void pointers and so on. And so yeah, in this function, what you're doing is converting the void pointer to x1 to an integer pointers, then dereferencing it, and the same for x2, and then we just take the difference, and that's it. Actually, yeah, the return isn't like minus 1, 1, or 0. It can be, if it's a negative number, it's before, if it's a positive number, it's after. Yeah, that's it. And yeah. And as a little bonus, I wanted to show also shellcode. And if you don't know, I mean, shellcode not as in like you're doing shell scripting, but as in yes, this one. Wait, no, it's not that one. It's shellcode. Something I took from this Stack Overflow post, which I will put in the description. I couldn't make it run on my machine, but as you can see, here we have an array of bytes, and this is actually just machine code. So they wrote some code in C or whatever and compiled it, and then they extracted the actual machine code and just put it in a C string. And then what you can do is convert that array of bytes to a function with a function pointer, and then you call it and it will execute this. And it's this way that I mean, I don't know anything about hacking, but obviously you can see that if your memory gets compromised somehow by an attacker and he manages to inject this kind of stuff into your program and then call it, You can very easily see how this could hijack a program and give unwanted access to some stuff. Anyway, that's it for function pointer. I hope you learned something. Maybe I should show how to make a type alias for them, because it's a bit tricky. So what you want to do is, again, see the definition order is weird, so you have to do this, then let's say my func, and then int, and that's how you do a type declaration, and the type is this. And so in my earlier example, could do something like this. Yeah, I mean, we don't see the print, but whatever. So yeah, this is easier when working with function pointers. If you have like a list, an array of them or something, and you just do a type def, because otherwise, if you have to type this a lot, you start to feel the pain. Yeah, anyway, that's it. See you in the next one.